2128 North Worcester, down there. How long did I have to stay? I volunteered for the Humane Society for about 20 years. I'm not speaking on behalf of the Humane Society as a volunteer, but just as a concern to me. During my time of volunteering, I had the opportunity to interact with Linda and the shelter employees on a regular basis. I always tried to keep a good working relationship because we were all hopefully working to the same end, you know, better conditions for animals. But there were many things that bothered me over the years, and I regret that I didn't say it in the last commission meeting, so I'm going to say it now. As a part of the Humane Society Community Outreach Program, I, along with other volunteers, went out into the community every week and met with pet owners in a goal to educate people about proper pet care and hopefully improve the life of animals in the community. I saw many things that were very disturbing, and I won't go into detail with this, but very many things. However, the most frustrating for me was the lack of enforcement of animal cruelty. And, you know, this went on for a long time. We were all very frustrated. And so we finally decided that the only way to improve enforcement was to strengthen animal control laws. So the Humane Society was very instrumental in strengthening those laws. And I think that the animal control ordinances now are fairly good. However, enforcement is still an issue. I've seen pets return to owners who neglect them to the point of cruelty. In my opinion, I guess they would return to their owners. I've also seen pet owners who were guilty of neglect and abuse, but were never charged because they were agreed to relinquish the pet. The fact that a pet is relinquished should not excuse pet owners from facing penalties for crimes. And I've seen that happen time and time again.